So let us play match the column now. Column 1 has 4 entries, A, B, C, D. Column 2 has 5 entries, P, Q, R, S, T. You have to match A, B, C, D with the P, Q, R, S, T options. A part says that F1 is a function from R positive to I, defined as F1x is equal to greatest integer of 1 by x multiplied by x then whole greatest integer, where box x represents the GAF function is. R positive is the given domain. F1x will take 3 cases. X equals to 1. Second case, x is greater than 1, that means 1 to infinity, open. Third case, x is less than 1, but positive, so 0 to 1, open. In the middle case, when x is equal to 1, both the greatest integer, the value is 1, so the answer is 1. Let us say x belongs to 1 to infinity. When x is a number greater than 1, 1 by x is a number which is less than 1. So inside greatest integer will go 0 because it will lie between 0 to 1. 0 into x greatest integer, the answer is 0. When x lies between 0 to 1, 1 by x will be greater than 1, but x will be again lying between 0 to 1 and it will be the reciprocal. So greatest integer of 1 upon x will be a number which is less than equal to 1 upon x multiplied by x, the number will be less than 1. Okay, so lying between 0 to 1, the answer is again 0. So f1x is either 0 or 1. Definitely it is a many one function q, and it is an into function also because the range contains only two elements, 0 and 1, whereas the codomain is the whole set of integers. Qs is the correct match. Let us move forward to b part says that f2 from r to r, defined as f2x is equal to sine of fractional part of greatest integer x plus greatest integer minus x, where square bracket represents GAF, curly bracket represent FPF. So we have f2x as sine of fractional part of a number greatest integer x plus greatest integer minus x. Greatest integer x plus greatest integer minus x can take two possible values, either 0 when x is integer or minus 1 when x is not an integer. So sine of fractional part of both of those values will be equal to 0, because fractional part of 0 is 0, fractional part of minus 1 is 0. So we have sine 0 and the answer is 0. So f2x is a constant function. Constant function is an even function. It is a into function and it is a many one function. QST is the correct match. Let us move forward to C part. C part says that f from R to R be defined as f3x is equal to ln of root of x plus 1 plus x. Students, this is a very careful observation. Root of x square plus 1 is always greater than x. That means the domain of this function is x belongs to R. Let us differentiate this function, f dash x. We'll get 1 upon root of x square plus 1 plus x multiplied by 1 by 2 root of x square plus 1 into 2x plus 1. So 2 will be cancelled. This will be root of x square plus 1 plus x. Here will be root of x plus x square plus 1. So that will be 1 upon root of x square plus 1. All the remaining terms are getting cancelled. F dash x greater than 0 for all x belongs to R. That means it is always an increasing function. An increasing function is always 1, 1 and on 2. PR. Okay. Let us move further to the last part of this question. D part. F from R to 0 open 4 close, defined as F4x is equal to 3 upon x power 8 minus x power 4 plus 1. F4x is 3 upon x power 8 minus x power 4 plus 1, which will be 3 divided by x power 4 minus 1 by 2 whole square plus 3 by 4. Students, numerator 3, denominator x power 4 minus 1 by 2 whole square plus 3 by 4, greater than equal to 3 by 4. So f4x is less than equal to 3 upon 0 plus 3 by 4. And at the same time, f4x is greater than 0 always, because numerator and denominator both are positive. That means f4x belongs to 0 to 4. This value is 4. Okay. So it is an onto function, given the codomain is open 0 to close 4. Definitely, if we replace x by minus x in this function, we are getting no change at all. So even function also. Talking about 1, 1 or many 1, any function which is even is always many 1, because f of x is equal to f of minus x. Q is correct. So QRT is the correct match for this particular option. Let us move on to 57. Question number 57 says that let fx be a quadratic polynomial such that f of minus 1 minus x is equal to f of minus 1 plus x for all x belongs to R. And f of 1 minus 4 whole square plus f of minus 1 minus 2 whole square is equal to f dash minus 1. Students, we have to match column 1 with column 2. It is a very careful observation that f of minus 1 minus x is equal to f of minus 1 plus x. Minus 1 plus x means you go x unit right of minus 1. Minus 1 minus x means you go x unit left of minus 1. The graph is a quadratic equation symmetric about x equals minus 1. That means this point has the x coordinate as minus 1, comma, let us say it be minus d by 4a, the standard coordinate. If this is so, f dash minus 1 is 0 because it has a horizontal tangent at x is equal to minus b by 2a. Now, let us assume fx is equal to ax square plus bx plus c. Students, what will be the conditions applied on this particular part? F dash minus 1 has gone 0. Sum of 2 squares is 0. So, f of 1 is 4. This is the first condition. F of minus 1 is 2. This is the second condition. F dash of minus 1 is 0. This is the third condition. So, from here, you will get fx is equal to x square plus 2x plus 5 divided by 2. Okay? That means fx is equal to x plus 1 whole square plus 4 divided by 2. That means fx belongs to 2 to infinity. Okay? The minimum value is 2 at x equals minus 1. Now, students, I need the value of cos inverse 1 upon fx, the greatest integer. So, 1 upon fx is a quantity which will be lying in 0 to half. So, cos inverse of 1 by fx will be a quantity which will be lying between pi by 3 closed to pi by 2 open. Pi by 3 is a value greater than 1. Pi by 2 is approximately 1.57. The only possible value of greatest integer of this interval is 1. So, P is the correct match for option number A. Okay? Let us move on to the next part. 1 plus signum of fx. So, fx is x plus 1 whole square plus 4 by 2. And fx belongs to 2 to infinity. If fx belongs to 2 to infinity, signum of fx is always equal to 1. Greatest integer of 1 plus 1, that is 2. Q is the only possible option. Let us move on to C part. All we need to know about fx is that it belongs to 2 to infinity. So, fx by 2 belongs to 1 to infinity. Tan inverse of this belongs to 4 to pi by 2. That means greatest integer of tan inverse fx. Pi by 4 is a value slightly less than 1. Can be either 0 or 1. Okay, depending on these values. So, PT is the correct match for C part. Okay, let us move on to last part. 2 cot inverse 2 by fx. So, fx belongs to 2 to infinity. 1 upon fx belongs to 0 to half. 2 upon fx will belong from 0 to 1. Cot inverse of this will belong from 2 upon fx will belong from pi by 4 to pi by 2. And further, this quantity will belong from, this complete quantity will belong from pi by 2 to pi. So, what is the greatest integer possibilities? 1, 2 and 3. P, Q and R. So, P, Q, R is the correct match for the last option. Okay. Let us move on to the next section.